Hey everybody, this is Claude Diamond. I am the author, if I can get out of the way, of The Haunted Investor. And if you want to find out more about this book, it comes in audio and written form, PDF, thehauntedinvestor.com, and it's just in time for Halloween. So it's a combination. I love creative real estate. If you know anything about me, I love sales, marketing, and I thought, what's a better way to learn about creative real estate and owner financing and fix-up property, which is a boarding house, and how to make it more profitable than to put it into a story form? And that's exactly what I did with The Haunted Investor. And I thought I'd read you a sec one of my favorite sections of the book. And just to give you a little background on it, my style of teaching people in real estate and sales and marketing is to always have a unique system or way of looking at business, doing it, and to teach it through I role play one-on-one, I mentor with my students, but also put it in a story form. Stories are, when you can learn by reading a story, I think it's much more entertaining, much more absorbing than reading an academic book and finding a cure for insomnia. So I wrote this book. It's about a couple guys. They want to start their own business. They look for a property that they can afford, and they have to deal. It goes back to the old days. They're doing business with the bully from high school, and they find a way to negotiate a property with owner financing, and they run into some problems, monetary problems. And the number one thing is that the property is so expensive and the cost of purchase and repairs that if they just rent it out to one person, they'll barely break even, probably lose money. So someone gives them the idea of making it into a modern day boarding house, Max the Mentor. And if you've read any of my other books, The Mentor Teaches Success. Here's a copy of that. The Mentor, The G.U.T.S Sales Rules, How to Sell with Guts. Let me see if I can get that on there. There you go. I've written a lot of books, and I always want to make teaching fun. So let me just, without further ado, let me get my share screen here, and I'll read you a little passage that I wrote it. And let's go right here. And there we go. Part nine, The Mentor. Well, as you can imagine, I didn't get much, or to tell you the truth, any sleep for the remainder of the night. But at least I temporarily resolved the specter negotiation. There's a ghost in this story, of course. In a secret room, too. Lucy the ghost didn't bother me for the rest of the night. I changed clothes at 5:30 a.m., went through the usual morning routine, and decided to focus on my meeting with Max. Hopefully, I would be getting a few suggestions on how to turn this albatross real estate deal around. I arrived at the Fireside Diner. I love diners, by the way. They are a disappearing American adventure in cuisine. Where else can you get a Taylor ham and egg sandwich on a fresh bialy at 2 a.m. in the morning, and a cherry Coke with a thick slice of ch strawberry cheesecake? Yes, I do love diners. This book, well, oh, by the way, off the book reading, this book might make you hungry. All my books have food in it. I arrived at the diner at 6:15, and lo and behold, there was Max sitting at the window booth facing the parking lot. Well, my boy, I am impressed. You are 15 minutes early. I may be old school, but I like punctuality. I have left many a meeting 30 seconds after the appointment time when the other person had not yet arrived. It's just the way I roll in life. My time, knowledge, and energy are my most valuable assets. I thought to myself, wow, this guy is impressive. No wonder they call him the mentor. Thank you, sir. A pleasure to meet you, Mr. Max. Just call me Max, he replied. I took the liberty of ordering you the special. Hope you're hungry. Little did he know I was famished. Coffee? You bet, I said as he poured me a cup of hot java from the carafe. The coffee is great here. They roast their own beans and grind them fresh every morning. He was right. This was one of the better cups I've had in a long time. I especially needed a caffeine boost after last night's experience. So, my young friend, let's get down to it. What is your urgent problem that you need my help with? Thank you, sir. I have an alligator. A property with six bedrooms and maybe another one I discovered last night. It's the one that's haunted. We bought it at an excellent financing, but we are drowning in repairs, and that were estimated at 85,000 and now we're at 165 and growing. I continued, we thought we could rent it out, but the way the numbers are working out, we will be losing $1,400 a month, and we just don't have it right now. We can't sell it either, just to break even and recover our investment. The market is in a lull right now, as you know. That's why I contacted you, Max. Do you have any ideas or suggestions? No, but I do have a solution if you're interested, he replied. You bet, Max. He began, imagine for a moment I could provide you today with a simple, low-cost idea for you to not only recover your monthly overhead, but to generate tremendous monthly rental and service fees from your home. By my estimate, your house could be generating a $3,500 monthly profit within the next 30 days, just by making some inexpensive modifications. What would you say to me next? I would say, yes, Max, please tell me more. Before I do, what are you willing to do in return? Anything within reason, just tell me. Can you take the pledge, make the commitment? I have the answer you want, but I want something in return, and it's not money. We discussed what he wanted. I didn't have a choice. It was like a scene out of the Godfather movie. Someday I may call upon you and ask you to help another. This day may or may not ever come, but if it does, you have to drop everything and keep your commitment to the Society of Mentors. The matronly waitress arrived with two monstrous plates of food. How you doing, Maxie baby? I bought you your favorite, the chef's special. Thank you, Emily. Please tell the chef I said thank you. The steaming, heaping plates were a combination of a Western omelet with melted cheese, corned beef hash, French toast, extra bacon, and a side of buttered marble rye toast. It was a massive portion of food. I thought to myself, how does this thin, very fit man, who looks as strong and healthy as a 2-year-old horse, eat all this stuff? We finished our meal, and Max looked at me with his piercing blue eyes. Are you ready for the solution? The answer, Dave, is simple. So off the reading here right now, we go into the solution that he offers him. And I'll just read you a little bit about this part too. This is the solution that Max offers. And all my books have this running theme that someone with a problem in sales or marketing or real estate meets this older, wiser, more successful person. Because I believe in mentoring. I believe that the right mentor, someone who is honest, successful in their own right, and accountable, someone like that can shorten the learning curve. Let me read you part of page 10 here. The solution. I leaned forward on the table, intent on listening to every word. I had my black and white grammar school composition notebook open with my fine point Sharpie pen ready to write down all of Max's wisdom. I probably looked like a begging dog waiting for a scrap from the dinner table. Here we go, my boy. Let's get to work. Are you familiar with the philosophy of Occam's razor? Not really, Max. It basically says that the common sense solution to a problem is usually the simplest. Let's summarize. You have an older but quaint home with a large kitchen, dining room, and a living room. In addition, you have six or more bedrooms with a multitude of bathrooms throughout the house. Between your mortgage, taxes, insurance, utilities, and major construction repairs, you cannot rent or sell the home without a catastrophic financial loss. Am I on point here? He asked. You got it, sir. I was amazed how fast he could ascertain and analyze a problem so succinctly. Max began. All you have to do is convert the bedrooms in the home to individual rentals, and the remainder of the house will be shared for common use. Based on your location, there is a tremendous demand for weekly or monthly units at a lower than market rent, similar to the old-fashioned boarding or rooming house, except you do not have to provide the food. It is cheaper than a hotel, and it's much more socially and friendly environment. There is a new trend, a new need for temporary housing for college students, business people, travelers, or just folks who cannot afford an expensive rental and who just need short-term housing. They want clean, modern rooms, privacy, but also the social aspect when they have the desire. You could hold TGIF, wine and cheese parties, every Friday for a nominal cost to you. Everyone would share a general kitchen, living room, and social environment if they so chose. All you have to do is have your contractor install dedicated electronic locks on the front main door and the individual bedrooms. When a person moves in, they use their cell phone as a key. You have an automatic log of everyone's coming and goings, and you can control the ingress and egress. They are willing to pay a much lower weekly rental fee and can move with minimal notice. No utilities to turn on and off, and no heavy-duty security deposits. The answer, my boy, is simple. All you have to do is convert your home to a modern-day boarding or rooming house facility, do a little grassroots social marketing, and get the place filled fast. By my estimate, your house could be generating a $3,500 profit within the next 30 days just by making some inexpensive modifications. You could also charge extra for fast Wi-Fi, a laundry room, a cleaning service, and bring in an additional $1,500 a month. Best of all, you get paid weekly, so you always have a passive cash income stream. And I'm going to end it right here at this point. And once again, my name is Claude Diamond. I'm the author of The Haunted Investor, and go to thehauntedinvestor.com if you'd like to purchase the book. It comes with the audiobook, which I recorded, and also the PDF. You can download it instantly. And it's a way of learning. And there is a specter, a poltergeist in this book, and it has a little romantic and interest in it. And the bully gets his comeuppance. And I don't think I'm giving away too much when I say there's a happy ending in this. I like writing business novels. Just as I said earlier, it's just, I think, a better way to learn. So for those of you interested in real estate or just want to read a fun novella on for Halloween that it combines business and some specter aspects of it. I'm no Stephen King, but I like to write and I like to teach people at the same time. My name is Claude Diamond. And my philosophy is nobody deserves success more than you good people. And I do answer my own phone, 619-206-5960, or go to my webpage, clauddiamond.com, or go to the hauntedinvestor.com. Thank you.